I want to talk tonight about the walk here on this side. The walk here on this side. Please excuse me. Take this, you're trying to keep me from coughing. But the walk here on this side. Amen. How many understand that the walk that Jesus has us walk in is a spiritual walk? How many understand that it's a spiritual walk? And the walk that you do on this side and how you carry yourself on this side shows plenty about your preparedness for the other side. It shows what you're prepared for on the other side. Go to Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11. In verse 13. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 13. I don't plan to keep you very long tonight because some of us will be on the road all week. And amen, praise the Lord. So we want to make sure that we're, you know, we're rested enough to do what we need to do, all right? But even in Hebrews 11 and 13, the Bible says these all died in faith, not having received the promises, having seen them afar off and were persuaded of them and embraced him and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. Now, what Paul was writing, and Paul wrote this in Hebrews chapter 11, and he began to talk about the old patriarchs of old, previously in the chapter. Chapter 11 talked about how Enoch was translated. You know, he talked about how Noah prepared the ark, and he began to even talk about, in essence, about how by faith Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place where he should, after receiving inheritance, he obeyed. He didn't know where he was going or what he was doing, but he obeyed. He talked about, amen, praise the Lord. Sarah, she received strength to bring forth children, and then he kind of puts all this in the same bucket in chapter 13, where he said these all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, were persuaded of them. The one thing that the saint has, and the reason why saints are different than every other group of people, is because of our faith. Our faith is not built on our now circumstances, but it's built on what we're receiving and what we're asking for in the future. And understand this, if you don't have a future in mind, then you'll waste your right now. As a matter of fact, you look at the world today, you look at a lot of the young people today, and amen, praise the Lord, and a lot of the destructive things that a lot of young people are doing. And if you ask them why they're doing some of the things that they're doing, they'll tell you, and they say, because life is short. I don't know what tomorrow's going to hold. They have a right now mentality instead of a future mentality. And because their right now mentality is like it is, they're locked in a mindset that is destructive. You understand what we're talking about? And some of us, because we don't understand the future, because we don't understand the faith dispensation that we're in a realm whereby we should be looking further. That's why this is called a faith dispensation that we're in. Because everything is built on what's going to happen in the future. And people say, well, how can you serve a God with everything that you see for us in the future? Because the future is what keeps me grounded today. When I understand, amen, praise God, that I've got a greater future than what my today is, it keeps me hoping for the greater tomorrow. So therefore, I don't spend everything I've got today. Amen. I don't shoot all my, amen, praise God, all my marbles in this one game, because I know there's some other games down the line that I've got to walk into. You understand what we're talking about? And therefore, amen, praise God, it makes us walk in a way so that we begin to see what the future is. Now, God comes in and looks at us, and God judges how we see the future and how we regulate today for the future. This is why the Bible says in verse 14, look what it says in verse 14. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. Now, and we talk about this further in verse 13, says, these all died in faith, not having received the promise, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. In other words, who is the they? For they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. The they are the saints. The saints that have a mentality and a mindset that because I seek a country that is greater than where I am right now, I'm changing how I walk so that I can have the future. I'm changing, amen, what I do today so that I can have tomorrow. I'm not going to, amen, cut up today because I know there's a tomorrow somewhere.
Yes.
And this, amen, praise the Lord, the Bible says this is how God sees us and compares us. That's why, amen, praise God, it says in verse 14, for they that say such things declare plainly that they seek a country. Declare to whom? Declare to God. They declare to God that they're seeking Him and how they're living their lives now. So if we walk in a way where everything is for a right now mentality, everything is right now, I've got to get all of my pleasures right now, I've got to get everything right now, saints of God, then you're declaring to God, amen, praise God, that you're not waiting for Him, but that you want all of your pleasures now. And the Bible says that if you want things now, you'll get them now. And you won't have what you needed for the future. That's why the Lord talks about the five wise and the five foolish virgins. He talked about how all the oil was used up. You see, amen, five virgins have the mentality of the right now. They have the mentality of the right now, so they burned up everything they had in the right now. The five wise virgins understood that their right now didn't exist until the groom came. And when the groom came, that was their purpose. And see, saints of God, we've got to understand our purpose. Our purpose is not for the right now, but our purpose is for when our groom comes.
Yes, amen.
The Bible says, amen, for they that say such things declare plainly, amen, that they seek a country. It is through my mindset of how I walk before God and in the areas of God that I declare to God that I seek a country. Over in Psalms 119, Psalms 119, in verse 19, the scripture reads to us plainly. Verse 17, start at verse 17, the psalmist, Jamil, writes, he says, deal bountifully with me, with thy servant, that I may live and keep thy word. Open thou mine eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. He says, I am a stranger in the earth. Hide not thy commandments from me. He said, my soul breaketh for the longing that it hath upon thy judgments at what? All times. So he says, at all times, my soul is breaking for something that's in the future. Jamil begins to go on and write in verse 21. He said, thou hast rebuked the proud that are cursed.